Grand Cayman has been a sanctuary for me. I moved here with my husband and children 3 years ago, but things have changed since then.
Hammer and shaver, and now they're split.
Blissfully happy. I think I'm ready for a fresh start on the island.
It doesn't work like that here. You're messaging me that I'm with your ex-husband.
I don't know you guys.
Because we wanted to escape. This place is popping.
It is the playground for the rich and famous.
So what makes Grand Cayman paradise?
She's not gonna last here. This is insanity. Sorry. Not sorry.
I would like to move forward.
Don't try to be part of my sphere. Actually, no.
Is how excited are you for this? For this show, and what really inspired this?
You know, I'm beyond excited. Like, the word excited doesn't even describe how I feel about this, because it's been a labor of love that started in the beginning of the pandemic. You know, I was watching people on Instagram and how, you know, the borders were closed here, but life was going on as normal, and everyone's having such a great time. And I was following people's Instagram feeds, and they were at Palm Heights at brunch and all kinds of other stuff while I was locked away in my house in LA. And it just really sort of gave me food for thought, right? Here's this paradise, idyllic place that in the middle of everything is still incredibly beautiful and hosting like the most incredible lives. And having been here from, you know, a little kid to now, to see the growth and change that Cayman's had over the decades, it just gave me a lot of food for thought to think about, okay, well, since we're this crossroads of the world with people from every socioeconomic background and you know, cultural area in the world, what does that mean when they all live together? You know, what does that look like when they coexist? And so just sort of being a person that's been studying folks for a long time and seeing how they interact, I thought what better place to do that than one of the most beautiful places in the world with some of the most incredibly fascinating folks in the world as well. So that is how Grand Cayman Secrets in Paradise was born. This has been such an incredible journey. You know, what we wanted to convey here was really sort of what life is like here for everyone that exists on our little rock. And I think we were really able to depict that in a very true and accurate way, and to really sort of dive into the lives these people are lucky enough to have while living here.
Was it intentional for you to shoot this docu-soap in Cayman? And why was it important to produce the show and have all things Cayman involved?
Well, as a multi-generational Cayman, it's impossible for me to not have this place in the back of my mind all the time. You know, I'm a permanent resident here now. I mean, I moved from LA to here as my home base. So it's always been sort of in the back of my mind. And I made a promise to my dad years and years ago that I would keep ties to the island, that I would make sure that I would do everything to make sure this place was able to get the due that it was deserved, right? And what better way to be able to highlight and showcase this place than on millions of TV screens across the world? And the idea of also really being able to help draw attention to our growing TV and film community here. So the idea of being able to bring a production here, hire local candidates, have them get the skills and training that they want for that, you know, developing industry here was important. So if I was able to really sort of pick up a show, bring it here and do what I love and be able to share it with, you know, people that share the same heritage as me, I think that was just a great opportunity to do that. So it was definitely a catalyst in wanting to bring that here, but truth be told, there's no better backdrop for a show either. So that played a big factor into it as well. You can't get a better, more beautiful set than this.
A few years ago, you mentioned to the Cayman Compass in an article that there is an environment here that needs to be shared with people. And I think you also added that Cayman doesn't get the attention, or it needs the attention, and doesn't get the attention that it deserves. And I feel, in a sense, you had it locked away. You had it kind of like locked in the back of your head that, you know, I'm going to do something. Do you still feel this way? And are we expecting more from this, being that we're creating a hub for film and productions?
Yeah, look, I think that is definitely something we've seen over the last few years, right? You've seen a production like this, you've seen multiple films being done here. And with the workings of the Cayman Film Commission and their, you know, pursuit of drumming up business to be able to come down here, and the incentive programs the government's working on to be able to have, you know, the production companies from around the world come here, see what we have to offer, but also have those financial incentives to come here. I think that that's definitely something we're working on in a show like this, you know, being able to be out there to show really what can be done here. Basically 10 hours worth of work being broadcast is something that I think is going to be a huge sell for other production companies. You know, we've had other studios come down already and take a look at what Cayman has to offer. You know, looking at things for, you know, multiple seasons of shows. We've had, you know, Paramount, we've had Netflix, we've had the NBC Universal folks involved in wanting to, you know, take a look at what you know, the islands do have to offer. Smart enough though, Freeform and Hulu with the first ones. So they got stuff right out of the gate. They were the smart ones, you know?